Yes, I think you are fine. Okay, dear kids, do you remember what have you learnt in your previous session of your class? Yes, you have learnt about the most three important characteristics of living things. What are those? Can anyone tell me what are the three characteristics you have learnt in your previous session? Yes, the first characteristic of the living things are living things move, first one. And the second one is living things need food. And the third characteristic is living things grow. So in today's session, we are going to learn about another three characteristics of living things. The fourth characteristic of living things is living things feel. Okay, dear kids? What do you mean by feel? Feel under kilo. Can anyone tell me? Yes. Before knowing about this characteristic, I am going to give you some examples. Okay? Let me give first example that think that in your home you are having a cat. Okay? Cat will be sitting in one place. Okay? In the corner or somewhere it will be sitting. So when you go in front of cat and you try to touch the cat, what it will do? What the cat will do? It will go away. Means it puts away. Means it makes out and it goes away. It will not sit there only. Why it is like that? Okay, I will give another one example for you. Hi dear kids. So now I am going to show you one activity regarding the characteristic of living things can feel. So dear kids, human beings means we come under the which category? We come under the category of living things. So how do we feel? What is the meaning of feeling? Let us now see through this activity. Okay, now I am taking one utensil here. Utensils mean patre. Okay, I took one utensil here. In one utensil I took a hot water. Okay, in another utensil I took cold water. I kept it in a refrigerator and I took it out after few minutes. So this is cold water and this is a hot water. Now I am going to touch the hot water utensil. What happens? You watch it clearly. Okay. What you will do when you touch the hot water utensil? What happens for you? You feel hotness. What you feel? You feel hotness. So with our bare hands, we can't hold the hot water. So what we do is, we use the holder to hold the utensil. So that time nothing will harm us. We can hold the utensil by this holder very easily. So coming to this cold water, when we hold the glass of this cold water, what happens for us? We feel cold. We took our hands like this back because we can't touch it for longer time. Like that hot water also, we can't touch the hot water utensil for a long time because we feel hot. For this cold water, we feel chill, means cold. So dear kids, only the living things have the characteristic of feelings, any kind of feelings. Okay, I think this example will be familiar with you, and this is the best example to show that living things have the feeling characteristic. Okay,
yes, we all do these things because why? We can feel. So only the living things have the characteristic of feeling. So dear kids, as like this, plants can feel the sunlight and it grows. When sunlight falls on the plants, it helps in the preparation of its food. So like this, and also in the growth of the plant parts like flowers, fruits, stem part. Like this, the plants uses the sunlight and it grows. So the living plants comes under the characteristic of living things. So dear kids, think that you throw this duster on the ground. Think that you thrown the duster on the ground. What happens for this? Does it feel any pain? No, because this duster comes under the characteristic of non-living thing. So non-living things do not have the characteristic of feeling. Okay, the fifth characteristic I am going to tell you is living things breathe. Fifth important characteristic is living things breathe. So, what I am going to tell you is, first let us do the activity regarding this characteristic. Okay? Dear kids, what I am doing here, you follow my words there. Okay? Now I am going to hold the right hand on my left chest. Okay? I am holding like this. So, what we do is, let us breathe. Okay? Let us take in the air. Like this. And we breathe out. Okay, let me do again it. I take in the air, means I inhale the air. What happens for me? Our chest goes up. When we inhale, that time our chest goes up. Okay, like that when we exhale, on that time our chest goes down. So this time we feel our breathing. So, we have the feeling sense, isn't it? So, we are having the breathing capacity. The non-living things do not have the breathing capacity. Living things cannot live without breathing. You remember that? Living things cannot live without breathing. So, this is the one example that this characteristic belongs. And another example is, so for every living things, there are the respiratory organs for their breathing. So, how do we breathe? We human beings breathe with the help of the lungs. What? With the help of the lungs, we breathe. And let me take another one example, that is butterfly. So, okay, butterflies breathe through some air holes, because in their body some air holes are present. Through that, the butterflies breathe. So third one, I will take a fish. How do the fish breathe? Fishes breathe with the help of the organ called as respiratory organ. Those are gills. So human beings breathe through the help of the lungs, and the butterflies breathe through with the help of the air holes, and fish breathe through with the help of the gills. So this is about the characteristic of living things breathe. So dear kids, you do one activity in your home. Let you take one doll from your home. Okay? With your doll will be there. Okay? Hold the doll in one hand and close the nose of the doll. What happens for you? Does it feel anything? No. It will not. So dear kids, the doll comes under the category of non-living things. So it does not have the characteristic of breathing. This is the fifth characteristic. And the sixth characteristic is living things reproduce. Living things reproduce. So, okay, in living things reproduce characteristic, let us learn about how the living things reproduce their young ones. Okay, how they give the birth to their young ones. So, dear kids, you already know that a bird lays eggs. A bird lays eggs. Bird lays the eggs. So from this eggs, a baby bird will come out. A baby bird will come out. So like this, the bird gives birth to the young one. So most new plants grow from the seeds. So think that one bird comes from another side, means it flews away from one plant to one tree to one tree. Okay, like that birds flews away every time. On that time, what it will do? It will eat some means fruits from the plant. Think that one bird eat a fruit from one plant and it throws the seed of that fruit for the ground. Why it flying away, means why it flying away from one tree to another tree? On that time it throws the seed onto the ground. So on the ground the seed fallen. From that process the new plant grows. From that process, on that same place the new plant grows. the generation of the plant grows up. So this is about the plant and this is about the birds. So coming up to the human beings, what the human beings will do? So I will take the example of one human being. What human beings will do? Human beings give birth to the young ones directly. Young ones. Okay. This is the process of reproduction. So like this, the living things reproduce. Like this, cow, cats, dogs. So these four living things give the birth to their young ones directly. So like this, the living things have the characteristic of reproduction. So dear kids, what have you learnt is, you have learnt about the reproduction process now. Do you think the non-living things will reproduce? No. This duster will not give the birth to the its young ones because it comes under the characteristic of non-living thing. So the non-living things do not give the birth to the young ones. This duster is the one example. You can see many examples like this. Okay? Can you name them? Yes. You make the list of that kind of non-living things which do not give the birth to the young ones. Okay, so dear kids, in today's session, this is the third session, I think so. In today's session, we have learnt about the three more characteristics of living things. What are those? Living things breathe, living things feed, living things reproduce the young ones. So let us meet in the next session with a new lesson.